Welcome to my YouTube channel, Fifth Frame between Mr. William and John Ashley. Before I start a video, don't forget to subscribe and press bell icon so you get all of my video notification. Without further delay, let's start a video. Mr. William successfully level scores. It's the second time Mr. Williams levels a score.
Half a chance then for Ashley from middle distance.
50-50 chance from Mr.
And he cued that just as well as Williams cued the red that clinched in the fourth frame. That was excellent from Ashley. It's been a very difficult season for him. Just one win.
Well played.
That was the international championship when he beat Jamie Clark in a decider. That's as good as it's got for him, aside from a couple of wins in the short format Championship League at the start of the season. So, coming here to Wales, playing one of the greats of the game, confidence would presumably have been low, but you wouldn't have thought so, given the way he's queued so far. He's competed well, he's potted some good balls, and he's earned this opportunity early in frame five.
Was a big shot though, wasn't it, in a way, just
that
to
was a big shot,
get
but
the moment,
he missed
it. He didn't make
it.
Really, really the pot or the position getting into that bunch. He didn't
between the red balls
inspire confidence in doing so.
Only recently underway on table two, of course, between Mark Allen and Xiao Yupeng. Meanwhile, Liam Davis leads the battle of the young Welsh talents, 2-0. Davis up against Riley Powell on table three. Coming up this evening, of course, we have the world champion, Luca Brasseur, who's not having the best time of things. Since lifting the big one at the Crucible last year up against Yang Jun, and that's followed on table one by Mark Selby, another player who's not been in the best of form of late, against Yuan Sijun.
One.
Very well cued red.
Well played.
Of course, those two were in the world final, weren't they? Selby and Brasseur. It's it seems a while ago now because the form has not been great, as you point out. Theory that Luca will be inspired by playing at the Crucible again
Six.
This year, the same way that our good friend and colleague Joe Johnson was a shot winner and got to the final the year after. You know, it's not out of the question Luca could do that. Ken Doherty did the same.
He's 53 on the one-year list, Luca Brasseur.
Yeah, amazing, isn't it? And I mean, he's got no issues with regards to rankings or anything, but I'd like to see him play better. I really like Luca. He's enjoyed the trappings of success. Now it's time to get back to business, I think, with the World Championships on the horizon.
Seven.
So vastly unable to make the most of the initial chance launched by that excellent long red to this right corner. Williams' turn as he looks to take the lead in this match for the first time.
12.
Could have worked out a lot better because he played it quite well.
To deft little open the balls.
Unless he's found it a plan, I'm not sure anything else he's on.
No, I don't think so.
Well, that end red might just creep past. I do think it goes. It's not an easy shot unless you're right behind it, though. The other plant he's looking at. He's not a lot better. Two reds quite a way apart. Not dead in line either. But at least this way he screws down the table in playing it out of harm's way.
Oh, good attempt.
A bit of a lackluster performance from Williams so far, isn't it?
70.
One of those, if you could just get over the line and regroup for tomorrow. But then he hasn't done that yet. You know, he's a long way from winning this match, it seems. He certainly played it. And, well, he could. If he didn't want to play a pot here, he could go in behind the black. Wouldn't be any fun to be playing, but this is a quite a big target.
Williams.
Well,
he's still going to hit, perhaps. He was quite close in behind the black. He had to go across twice, and he has missed a snooker this time by way.
Foul.
And red to middle will certainly interest Williams here. He steered that cue ball in behind the black, having potted the red. Terrific shot. Well, you just feel that maybe Mark Williams is finally coming to terms with this match. I thought the red he knocked in was very good, and now it's actually created an opportunity to get to the front. And he hasn't led in this match, and if it's only 3-2, I think that was still feel quite a psychological boost to him.
A short match to get to the front.
In a match he's not really played well in. He's just been battling against the elements so far this afternoon.
Charlie Peng and Mark Allen in the background there. Allen's taken the opening frame with a break of 66 to lead Chow 1-0. That's on Discovery Plus, table 2.
Now Mr. John getting nervous.
Yes, that may have gone wrong. It's actually quite similar to the a black that Neil Robertson missed earlier on against Jackson Page, which cost him the frame from a long way in front. It's almost like this. And he hasn't missed it, but he hasn't got position either.
He missed the position.
Mark Williams, 22.
Well, a bit of a nothing shot there from Williams, but probably there was nothing else he could do. Probably just drop into the red. Andy lead this in this frame. Only 5 points. The 3 times world champion. So for the first time this afternoon, Astley now chasing the match a little bit. He's been calling the shots until now. It's a slight mistake. He thought he could get the cue ball down,
mistake,
but he didn't bargain on a red.
Mr. Williams, there is
heading in the same direction as the cue ball.
Available for Mr.
Not
John
an easy
Ashley.
First ball, but Williams didn't want to leave anything like this, just in case it goes in, and chance to get right back into the frame if it does. Needs help. Needs luck. Goodness me, he doesn't want that one back, does he? He'd be more than happy. Pink could have ended up blocking the black pocket, but that didn't happen either, so all results like that gratefully received. So interesting point of the match again.
Eight.
With the Williams not killing off this fifth frame, and now Astley with this counter-attack.
Nine.
Again, position the black.
First turn pro back in 2013. Fell off the tour a couple of years later. Got back on in 2016, and then of course was relegated again in 2020 before returning at the beginning of last season. But reasons already
16.
Explained. Facing a similar scenario as we head towards the climax of this season, needing
17.
Points and probably a good run. The World Championship, of course, there's 10 days of qualifying in order to preserve his professional status.
I suppose he could have played on the red down the cushion
24.
There, but players invariably don't do that with other reds available, but he might not get a better chance to be on it than the one he had there off that black.
25.
Now he's slightly wrong on the blue. Quite straight, he might be able to just force an angle. And it will come down, I think, to that red, which he needs prime position behind.
30.
What he doesn't want to do is finish low on the black, where he has no shot to get on the red. Well, I'm not sure what he's played there, but he's not the answer. But he's not the answer. And if he played to knock the pink out, did he? Really not sure. I think he only had to roll it in and finish top side of the black, and it's problem solved.
Try to release a pink ball from a cushion.
All of the angles here. Oh, it's a great effort. This is a really good effort.
What an effort from Mr. S.
Very fine shot.
Very fine shot from Mr. Astley.
He's got a very slight angle, that's all.
Got a slight angle.
Pretty good shot though.
Missable shot. He missed the shot.
Calamity. Double kiss. Looks as though Williams can clip this red in.
Quite amazing that he left the red on in the way, wasn't it, with the cue ball going into that left corner. Got and the red. Somehow the red became possible, which seemed
a green ball and
far-fetched, I think, in running.
A yellow
he
ball.
Didn't know what to do on the red. He didn't, neither one thing nor the other. He could have rolled it in, and he wouldn't have missed it, I don't think. He played it full-bloodedly, but he was somewhere in between.
Six.
So Williams just needs green, brown and blue to hit the front for the first time.
Need green, brown and blue ball.
Yeah, but if he wins this frame
to confirm
in this
victory,
manner, I think he's
to win a frame.
Big boost for Williams and a quite body blow for Astley. Because he really had a chance to win it himself, as we saw just then.
And he played that terrific 13. Positional shot. Going round the houses off the black for the red, but fortunately for Astley, not only did he miss the red, but that double kiss left it for Williams. Could easily have got away with it, he didn't. And it's cost him the frame.
18.
Well played.
So, well, afternoon.